So even though it's cloudy, we should stay dry tonight. The sun will come out again during the day tomorrow. Jerry?
All righty. Thanks so much, Craig. And what wonderful weather for gazing at the heavens above. And that's what we're going to be talking about today on Live at 5. We came out to the James C. Veen Observatory in Lowell, which is really kind of a homemade affair, but one of the most sophisticated in the United States. This guy right here, his name is David DeBryan, and he is he runs the place out here at the James C. Veen Observatory. This is a homemade telescope, and we're going to be talking more about that. But right now, sir, I understand that we've got an eclipse coming up that we'll be able to see. Why don't we explain that to the folks at home?
The most significant eclipse of the sun since 1925.
Wow.
Just around the corner, May 10th, right about midday.
Okay.
And with proper precautions, everybody can watch that eclipse.
That's a good thing. Now, I understand we have some pictures of an eclipse that happened in the past. Why don't you tell us about that?
This was an eclipse of the sun that was total, and that was visible in 1991.
Okay.
You had to travel a long distance for that. In this eclipse, the sun is going to go right across, the moon's going to go right across the central face of the sun, but it won't quite cover it like that photograph, so you'll still see a little ring of brilliant sunlight called an annulus. It's called an annular eclipse.
Now that's going to be visible right here in western Michigan.
Not the annular part. A very near annular eclipse will be here. You have to travel a little farther south in the state along a very narrow band that will be across the lower part of the state to see that particular part of it.
It's going to be a wonderful phenomenon. We're going to talk more about that coming back. He's even got a device that you can make at home that'll make it safe for you to view that eclipse. But when we do come back, what we're going to be talking about are some of the wonderful pictures they've actually taken from these great telescopes here at the observatory. We're going to take you to outer space, a place you've probably never been, when Live at 5 returns. Lippershey would have been proud of this moment right here. You know who Hans Lippershey is? He's the guy that invented the telescope back in 1608. He was a Dutch optician and came up with the idea, and then 1 year later, Galileo said, hey, that sounds like a pretty neat idea. I'll make one of my own. And Galileo, most people think, invented the telescope, but no, it was that Dutch guy, Hans Lippershey. Whoa, busting the place up here. This right here is David DeBryan. We are out at the James C. Veen Observatory in Lowell, which, as I was saying earlier, is kind of a homemade observatory. Why don't you explain how that whole thing came about?
It was almost from the ground up. The members of the local astronomy club have been working on this facility essentially for almost three decades now. It was built in the late 60s. We're constantly improving it, adding new telescopes and equipment all the time. We are in operation here every clear night, almost. However, we only invite the public up on special occasions. Mm-hmm. We've got some of those coming up. This Saturday, in conjunction with the area-wide science festival, we're going to be open here from about, I believe, 1 o'clock in the afternoon right on through about 11 o'clock at night, regardless of weather. You can come on up here and see the telescopes, view our slideshow, learn about the eclipse that's coming up. And if it's clear, we'll be observing the sun during the day and observing Jupiter, Venus, the moon, and a number of other things at night. And then the following week, we start our regular visitors' nights, which will be on the second Saturday and last Friday of each month.
Okay, we'll
so
get all that
Friday the 29th, I believe, is the first one where it'll be clear.
We'll put all that information on the Live at 5 hotline so folks can get in touch with it. But right now, let's talk about this telescope a little bit. You guys built this thing from scratch, is that
right? This is our principal instrument here. This is the 12.5-inch reflecting telescope. It's one of three fairly sophisticated instruments which we have at the observatory, together with some smaller telescopes. It can be pointed to any part of the sky, just like you're doing. You know, you can move it around quite effortlessly.
Yeah, you really can.
And the light comes in the end, reflects off a big mirror at the base of the telescope, comes back up to a smaller mirror, and then reflects out to the side where the eyepiece is located.
All right, and now you've taken some great pictures with this.
You've
to do that. Why don't we roll the tape of that right now, and you can tell us what we're looking at, David.
Some of them are time exposures. This is the crescent moon, as you would see it through the instrument, pretty much how it would appear if you were to look at it visually.
Mm-hmm.
That's very early in its monthly phase cycle.
And you saw that with this telescope here?
Oh, yes, yes. Most of these pictures were actually taken with it. This is kind of a bubble of gas blown off by a star. It's called the Dumbbell Nebula, and a very interesting object to astronomers. Again, this picture was not taken at Mount Palomar. This was taken right here with this telescope.
That is just, and you guys built this thing. That is
That's the Orion picture. Nebula. You can see that with your naked eye on a really good night in the constellation Orion. It is marvelous through the telescope visually, and as you can see from the photograph, it's very impressive. This is where we think stars are born, this birthplace of stars. The Hubble Space Telescope's taken some neat pictures of that.
Look at that, that looks like a fireworks display. So
this is another nebula. I think we call this the Eagle Nebula. You see it in the summer sky, but you need a telescope. You can't see it with the naked eye.
Boy, that is just wonderful stuff there, David. And once again, folks, you know, you can come out here, call the Live at 5 hotline a little later in the evening. We'll have all the information about how it is you can come out to the James C. Veen Observatory and see some of these great things and talk to some great people like right. Dave right here. When we come back, though, we're going to talk about kind of a do-it-yourself way to see the heavenly bodies above, and that is buy a telescope of your own. How much do you have to spend? We're going to tell you in just a couple seconds.
9618. Tell you what, they got a lot of telescopes out here at the James Veen. This one, we got one over here, and there's even one down in that little box over there. So if you want to come on out here, there's another number for you to call. That's 897-7065. That taps you directly into the James C. Veen Observatory in Lowell, where you can come out and see the stars. Have a great day. Hope my voice is back tomorrow. See ya.
Hope so too, Jerry.